Hello and welcome back to Shadow of the Tomb Raider. We've got to get in somehow, and we're not allowed to go over the bridge, so I guess we're gonna have to go around. I thought I'm starting to do this and no one sees me doing it. That doesn't seem to be the way to go. Was that rock spurting blood? That was weird.
Impossible. I can't carry anymore. Here's Quetzalcoatl, the feathered serpent. The Aztecs worshipped him as a force of nature, responsible for the wind and the rain. In his most wrathful tempers, these natural phenomena became extreme, acting to cleanse the earth and sky. Through that, he also became associated with justice and with mercy. According to one legend, he had misbehaved with his sister, and to atone for his shame, he set himself on fire. Then, his ashes rose into the sky, and he became a god of light as well.
Yeah, the rock spurting blood. I get back over there. Damn.
May the rivers of the afterlife be calm, and Uturanku's boat sturdy to ferry us across them.
Nice. There is a thing over there I want to get to. just one monolith there. There's a few things I want to get. Not sure if this is the required path or what.
I can barely see the bottom. Hope there is a bottom.
There must be a way down that doesn't involve plummeting all that way. I expect that probably shouldn't have worked, but...
This cavern must have been carved by an underground river.
There's loads of gold spots over there, but I need to figure out how to get to them. I don't think I took the correct way. Or at least the intended way.
Up there. Something behind us. That's not good.
But the animation and sound effects don't appear to be synced with the model every single time. I'm surprised no one actually noticed or fixed it. I don't know if there was a thing there, I don't know, I wasn't paying too much attention. Anyway. Maybe I was supposed to jump down. Considering the only way back now is to swim up. Possibly fits, considering I might be able to get those gold spots. Jade.
Just crossed the river, almost at the prison. There are guards everywhere.
We're heading towards the river. Get back to you when we're there.
Okay.
The box is not in Paititi.
I know.
I will be forced to join Amaru. Everything I fought for since Heidi's death will be lost.
I won't let that happen. Come on, let's go.
We're out of time. Someone needs to find that box. If the sun is not recharged, or the world we made, all of us will be destroyed.
I found another clue. Maybe. The tattoos on your arm, the heron and the eclipse, the same symbols were found engraved on the altar where the box was taken.
What?
What do the symbols mean?
This one shows my destiny. The crimson fire of Chakchin. And this one grounds my past. It symbolizes Chimchichika, the last true emperor of Paititi. His tomb is in the upper district.
Can you take me there?
They're all over that tomb. If there's anything there, they would no doubt have found it already.
Amaru doesn't have this clue. He doesn't know what to look for.
He's going to be crawling with guards.
We'll find our way around them.
It'll be dangerous.
I'm sure.
Then there's no time to waste. How is Edsley?
Safe. He helped me find you. He should be with Uchu now.
Hit my mic.
Jonah, I'm with Inuratu.
Oh, good. Edsley wants to talk to her.
Mother, we're sending backup. Should I support Uchu or use the distraction to seize territory?
You're in charge while we're separated, Edsley. Trust your instincts.
Leitchkalan koele lo putzi, hachpila with job.
Bash lehelo, telo, ichi lechi wobo, shena wile,
to say bani.
Let's go.
Dilapa.
This describes something nearby. A once ferocious warrior, raised as a warning. It fell from his mouth and now lie beneath him. All full up. Can't carry any more.
Ooh, another crit.
I don't have enough space for that.
Also,
quite the grim welcoming committee. The victims were offered to the gods. They left the cities and wandered the provinces until they were buried alive. Kukul Khan departs Paititi during New Moon. Kukul Khan returns, with several other outsiders, during the waxing of the moon. They argue. The next morning, the entire group, now in better spirits, leaves in their obsidian birds. Quite the grim welcoming committee. Have to find another way out.
There's only one that I haven't found yet.
These traps are more complex than I could have imagined. May Quispi have acquired a surplus of foods, supplies, and comforts by the time we meet him in the afterlife. Murder. Death. Stealing another's crops. Death. Stealing another's skins. Death. Idleness. Head shaved, fighting, restitution to injured party, public drunkenness, stoning, exceptions, during a festival or over 70 years old, by order of the cult of Kukul Khan. The victims were offered to the gods. They left the cities and wandered the provinces until they were buried alive.
So, there's only one more crypt to find, which I'll have to do at some point. How do I get back? Not like that. That bloody rock. I continue. I missed a survival cache. Thank you. And then the other one, before I end this episode, I want to try and find the cache, the monolith. Informing us. It was once ferocious warrior raised as a warning. I fell from his mouth and now lie beneath him. Over there. The question is, how do I even get over to that? There's something there. I guess it will be something. Yeah. Anyway.
All full up. Can't carry any more. This will be useful.
Huh. Missed a document.
The ruling family is displaced, reduced to nothing but a figurehead while we truly control the city. The reason for allowing them to remain in position of seeming power is twofold. It allows us to focus on our search for the silver box
and it acts as a pacifier for the locals who are recalcitrant to any type of change.
Interesting. So yeah, I'm going to leave this episode here. If you've enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe, and have a good one.